now I request Mr. Anis, important area of implementation of the policy in the defense studies and about the defense curriculum. Mr. Anis, please go ahead and share your thoughts.
Thanks, the Akram Bhai, the Policy Times, and Shivnada University for holding such a interesting session, World Education Conference. I'll directly come to the point. My name is Anis Kutty and I run a defense coaching institute. What I'm talking right now is something different than what things were already discussed right from the beginning today. I am into defense coaching. Defense coaching means how can children enter Indian Army, Navy, Air Force through various exams conducted right from first standard to 12th standard. See, the child can start learning. The new education policy will definitely help a child to learn four important aspects. That is maths, English, aptitude, and the most important part is psychology. If the four things are known or the four things are taught, then schools will also will not be a matter, or the reach will not be a matter. Most important thing is the language, the literacy, the numeracy, the aptitude, and the skill, that is psychology. Now, there are Navodaya schools in every district of India, and there is an entrance exam for this Navodaya schools. And the Navodaya school entrance exam is in 20 regional languages. So please, language will not be a barrier for them. But the skill is important. That means a child has to prepare from standard 1 to 5. A boy or a girl who gets into Navodaya, indirectly we are helping that boy or girl with 5 lakh rupees from the government of India. So the life, uski life ban jayegi. You know, you don't have to worry about that child. So even if we are able to, with the new education policy, we'll be able to reach the unreached. That is the most important thing which I'm trying to comment. You know, India has to reach the unreached. There is a wide divide between the haves and the have-nots. The urban and the rural divide. The village and the city. You know, the things which IITs, IIMs and Navodayas. There's a lot of difference. All the Navodayas and rural areas. Then I come to every district has got, every state has got a Sari school. Maharashtra has got two. Bijapur has got two. So that is most important. Can you come to the previous slide, Akram Bhai? So what I was talking about is, I'll not take the more than 4 minutes. We have to come from existence to excellence, which is what I'm trying to tell through the new education policy. And we have to bring the communities from isolation to mainstream, which is very much important. And we have to empower the communities of education. Education will be the only tool, the next slide. Education will be the only tool which will help to grow our economy in all aspects. Now, I won't be talking more on this. I'll be talking more about Sainik schools. I'll be talking more about Rashtriya Military Schools, which is 5 in India. I'll be talking about RIMC, Rashtriya Indian Military College, which is in Dehradun. Only school where one boy is selected from one state. Remember, every 30 students in every 6 months. That particular exam is far tougher than the Chinese government exam. You know, China claims that Gaokao is the toughest exam in that age group. A boy from 6th standard directly goes to the 8th standard. So look at the intelligence level, look at the quality. You know, the next slide. There are four questions which are important. The adversity quotient, the intelligence quotient, you know, the social quotient. You'll find, you know, during your school days also, those children who are toppers are not doing well, but the average children are doing well nowadays. So the new education policy will help each and every average student also to perform well in whatever field they are in. So what I'm trying to do is, you know, what I call problem-based learning, project-based learning, purpose-based learning, which is an international concept. You know, the new education policy has introduced, along with literacy, they talk about numeracy, which is a phobia in the entire world. India can contribute to mathematics on a very large scale. Indians are better mathematicians than any other country. Look at the SAT exam, look at the GRE, or even if you look at IELTS. If you see the Olympiads, the mathematics level of Indians are far better than anywhere in the world. So I saw a participant from Bhutan, from Bangladesh. You know, I'm here. You can note down, you can connect me, and I can help you to eliminate mathematics phobia throughout the world, which is very important for to understand artificial intelligence, machine learning and data science. See, artificial intelligence, machine learning and data science needs maths. Without mathematics, the world cannot go up. And Indians are very good at mathematics. And that is why through puzzles, through games, through school cinema, if you visit my YouTube channel, I've used Amar Akbar Anthony, Chandal Chokadi, Mara Mari, such colloquial Bombay language, so that it becomes easy for anybody to understand mathematics. You know, mathematics has to be presented in a very simplified manner, which has not been done in the world. So India can look upon, the world can look upon India for leadership qualities in mathematics. The next one. And you know, the isse pehle wala slide, Akram bhai. See, this is very important. No, not iske baad wala. Yeah. This is something which is Anis classes has patented about. It is called project-based learning, problem-based learning, and purpose-based learning. Which is, you can teach a child in a class 10 how to build a swimming pool in a hotel using calculus. So you can understand application of derivatives or application of calculus. And already NCERT has introduced application-based sums in the syllabus. New education policy has to implement that. Next one. So I was talking about maths. I was talking about, how we can improve the skill. In order to enter different competitive exams, 300 mathematics ka paper is there, conducted by the UPSC. The NDA exam is conducted by UPSC, the only pre-graduate exam conducted by Union Public Service Commission. And you have to clear a 300 marks mathematics, which has got 120 questions to be covered in 150 minutes. And we are the pioneers in solving multiple choice questions with a single answer, which nobody in the world can do it. So please connect with us. We can help you in explaining those things. Next one. The assessment pattern has also changed. The scenario has changed. Even children who have taken arts can enter into IIT. Children who are into IIT, as Dr. Sahasrabuddhi also said, that they are going into, someone is asking me how a person who doesn't go to school or somebody who's not into school can help. See, there is no need to go to school. 40% of people in IIT in Pune has tried to understand the concept of no schooling and homeschooling concept. It is already implemented in Pune. Number of couples who are working in IIT are not sending the child to school. So whatever crisscross subjects are available in NEP, already it is in existence in Pune. So there are a lot of, you can write the questions, we can answer it later on also. I don't want to go off track. What I'm trying to tell is, if somebody wants to give an IB ka exam, UPSC, CDS ka combined defense service ka exam, coastal guard ka exam, railway exam, bank exam, the mathematics that we teach in 10th, 11th, 12th, is the same. But if you are in an ICC board or a CBSE board or a state board, a child just mugs up the answers. Abhi ratta nahi chalega, satta chalega. That is my line. Unless and until concepts are not cleared and the teachers are not trained, we conduct free teacher training courses, because the implementation of education policy is possible only if the teachers are trained to do it. Otherwise, it will be a flop like what happened with CCE. The continuous comprehensive evaluation. It was not properly implemented because the teachers were not trained. So I believe in teachers training. Even no matter what qualified they are, how well they are, these people are teacher. The quality of a teacher can be understood by the way, with the power they can engage with the children. If they're not able to engage with the children, they cannot. You don't have to teach them rocket science. You have to teach them basic elementary maths, elementary geometry, elementary algebra. Which is way behind. People are not understanding things. How to find the angle between the hour hand and a minute end of a clock. If it is 720, the angle between hour hand and minute end of the clock is 100. How do you get that answer? It's very simple. But these things are way beyond the imagination of teachers also. So how to teach in shortcut methods, how to, improve their memory techniques, and how to evaluate things, and how to make mathematics simple, is something which you have to understand, especially in the new education policy, which I repeat, that is the only thing that I'm repeating. And I was happy to see that wherever they have been mentioned about, literacy, they have mentioned about numeracy. So numericals, mathematics, numbers is going to be a big thing. Somebody wrote about triads. We are talking about Pythagoras triads. Pythagoras is something that's very easy, 3, 4, 5, 3² + 4² = 5². But it is going to be used world over. Pythagoras triads are used in trigonometry. The conclusion is, mathematics is the thing that has to be given more importance along with language. I have coined a new term. It is called as Manglish. In order to understand mathematics, your English has to be also very good. So mathematics and English are the key roles which the new education policy implementers, especially the high stakeholders, the teachers, and third party like us who are running coaching classes should understand or should be given more importance to, so that it becomes easy for children from rural area also to clear the exams. For that, I will always, I repeat the things which I've already said. We have to come from existence to excellence and from isolation to mainstream. And third, importance has to be given to education. You know, how we gave importance to COVID or the pandemic. Now, in order to overcome the situation, we have to give importance to education, and education at very grassroots levels. And education should be available to everyone without any discrimination. That can be only possible if we are teaching them with all our efforts. Thanks a lot. And I'm very happy to share the screen with all of you intellectuals out here. And thank you, the Policy Times and Shiv Dadra University.